Hey there, and welcome back to my channel. In this video, we'll be discussing how to create a realistic level design using Gaia Pro and Jenna Pro. If you are interested in game design, then this video is perfect for you. So let's get started. Before we start creating realistic level design, we need to have Jenna Pro and Gaia Pro installed in Unity. Gaia Pro is a talent and scene generator, while Jenna Pro is a procedural spawner that populates the scene with assets. Once you have both plugins installed, we can start creating our level. As you can see, we successfully added Gaia in our project. We need to go to our top menu from window, then you can find procedural walls. Then from there you can go to Gaia, then show Gaia manager. Also, you can click on Ctrl G, it will pop up the Gaia Manager window. So as you can see, there are some errors. One is for post-processing, one is for a different rendering path. You can just click on the button, it will switch the rendering path. Also, you need to install the post-processing stack if you want to use built-in render pipeline. So I will go to the package manager, then import post-processing stack from Unity registry. So we are ready to create our new world. So from one size we'll take large, then target platform should be desktop and target biome should be alpine medio, and we'll choose manual stamper. So here you can see the stamper. There are a lot of stamps for you can choose any of them. I prefer to use some island, also mountain. After choosing your right island or terrain, you can just click on the apply. Also, if you see the right inspector window, there you can see some details. You can increase the height. You can also do some modification to your scenes or terrain without stamping them. So if you press stamp, it will bake all the texture to the terrain. Also you need to create the biome. So I press the stamp button and it will generate all the textures, and it will bake the texture around the curvature. Based on the curvature, then we can go to the next window and we can create a runtime. It will create a first person shooter and post processing, also lighting to our scenes. So as you can see, there are no trees yet. You need to create the biome. So without the biome, there will be no trees, no grass. So if you like this type of video, let me know. But also, if you want to know more in details for Gaia or Jenna, also any other asset, let me know in the comment. I will try to create a video for it. So as you can see, it instantiates all of the assets in our scene, and it is within 5 minutes you created the level design, almost natural and also realistic. So for now, I will add Jenna Pro. So we can also import both of them at the same time. But I created them, created the terrain. After that, I will import the Jenna plugin. So Jenna will sample the terrain height and all the things. Then if you spawn anything, it will generate the asset based on the terrain. So if you think you want to create a building, so you just place the building in the scene. After placing that, you need to adjust the terrain, or you need to adjust the building according to the terrain, right? So but Jenna already doing it for us. So we'll use flooded ground from Unity Asset Store. It is also free and it is a great plugin. You can use that. It already downloaded. While importing, you only need to check the check content and prefab and uncheck all of them. So because if you import everything, there will be error with post-processing and other things. So for safety, you just check content and prefab. So after importing flooded grounds, and go to procedural world, then go to Jena, then asset sample package, then we'll content pack and import flooded ground from there. Just click double click on that, it will import the package. So just from procedural walls, you need to go to content packs and you need to go to the spawner folder. Just go into the spawner folder and drag the spawner, any of the spawner and you want. By shift clicking, it will sample the terrain, and if you click control and click right click, then it will form the object around the terrain and deform the terrain also. So it will also remove the trees and rocks, but it will not update the textures. So once we are happy with the changes with the terrain, we'll go to Gaia tools, then Alpine menu, and spawn the biome again. It will generate the texture around the according to the terrains. So creating big levels nowadays is not hard task. In previous time, it took a lot of time to create the level, then create the biome also. But now we have a lot of plugins, and I think in future there will be some AI tools, and like I think Gaia will also implement AI to their assets. So most of the plugin will be based on AI, so they will be able to create a lot of realistic model or terrain according to their data. So I will fast forward this and show you after some time. Now we can create a river flow. So river, creating river in by Jena, it is very easy. You just go to the hierarchy and right click. You will see Jena in the bottom of the list, and click on the spawner. You can see the river flow. So by clicking that, you can just click anywhere in the scene. Just control click. It will sample the ground by any scene sample. Clicking control and right click, it will create the spline according to the terrain. So there are some by curve. It will curve the terrain also. As you can see, and it is deforming our scene. Also, there are some river package, river tools. You can increase the depth, increase the width according to your scene, according to the place. So you can drag and drop, you can move the spline just clicking on the dot. As you can see, green dot. So possibilities are endless if you want to create some good quality, good level design. If you spend some time with the Gaia, you'll be able to master the Gaia tools and spawner within short period of time. So after that, we'll create the curve this. After carving that, we'll bake the texture also, bake the river also. So sometime trees did not removed after clicking on clear trees. You just need to respawn the biome from Alpine menu biome in the Gaia tools. So it's already baked, and we can go to the Alpine bio and spawn the biome again. So after that, the texture will be baked again. As you can see, the tree river is working and it is flowing down to the sea. So after that, we'll create the root system. But by same process, you can just go to hierarchy and click on Gemma and add root spline. So just click on control and right click, it will create the spline and create the root. If you want to move it up and down, you can do that by the gizmo also. If you want to merge any time or intersect between the root, you can just click the last point and click on the any type of any middle point. It will merge both of them and create the intersect. So as you can see, I finished up with the root design. So now I'll carve the root as in a similarly we did on the river spline. Now you can adjust the width and curve. So that's it. And you can experiment other things too. So as you can see, after clicking on the baked texture, the Gaia Terrain is modified according to the texture and root size. So sometimes there might be some ups and downs. You need to just go to Terrain and adjust it according to your needs. So I also forward this first and forward this and see you after this. And let's see, let's have a look with play mode. Let's have a look with the play mode. Let's have a look with the play mode. As you can see, I haven't adjust the respawn the biome, so that's why there is some remaining grass on that roads. Also our flowers, might be some rocks. So let's see. And I think if you click on the spawn the biome, it will solve the problem. Let's see. And spawn the biome, it will remove the all textures and grass from the seeds. So as you can see, after spawning the biome, there are no grass in the roots. That's it. By using Gaia Pro and Gemma Pro in Unity, we can create realistic level design with ease. We can create vast environments that are both beautiful and immersive. I hope you find this video helpful. Don't forget to like and subscribe to my channel for more game development and design content. Thanks for watching.